The history of the world according to the NCRA players. The birth of the recycling movement. What? You think that recycling has existed from time immemorial? Or at least since the 1800s? Or at least since the 1940s? Or at least since the 1970s? No! The history of the recycling universe began in 1999. With the birth of the NCRA players. Because nothing exists until you put music to it. Sam Best defeated flow control and the take make waste industrial complex by solving the mystery of zero waste. 2000, earnest young senator Mr. Chesbro goes to Sacramento to thwart the plastic lobbyists who have lined up against him. Sometimes, you can just filibuster your way to zero waste. It's still the same old story. A fight for love and glory. And the beginning of a beautiful friendship at Rick's place. Rick, we will always have Fresno. 2002. Nothing happened because the NCRA players were on hiatus. However, CRRA wised up after that. 2003. The age-old rivalry between recyclers and zero-wasters nearly came to blows on the mean streets of Waste Side Story. But star-crossed lovers showed us we could come together to defeat the phantom of the landfill and the specter of conversion technology. Hada Rai and her red boots. Now this was about zero waste. And so was this. But this one had pirates. And this one had Trojans. But this one was just about zero waste. 2010. In Briefcase Full of Blues, we got the band back together to save the world from imminent mass destruction and raise money for zero waste. 2011, going incognito with our two leading men in Some Like It Rot was never a drag. Our heroes made zero waste look easy, and they had to do it in high heels and backwards. 2012, the Governator and Lady Gaga helped the men in black save our planet from invaders, our wasteful selves. 2013, the two snakes. This one had snakes in it. And zero waste. 2014, single-use bad boy Danny fell hard for zero waste good girl Sandy over the intoxicating fumes of duty's anaerobic digester in Greece. In 2015, our hero didn't have a clue, so he enlisted the services of Nancy Drew and her crack team of junior waste sleuths. 2016, nocturnal guilt conjured the specter of recycling's past, present, and future. Zero waste us, everyone. 2017. Like the ancient mariner, we are destroying our albatross and our mermen, who are drowning in plastics. The only solution is zero waste. 2018. A sea change on the love boat. Gross consumption and opulent overindulgence collide with the Pacific garbage patch and the bad ship Nobro. 2019, we're on the road to Rancho Mirage. What do you think, guys? Hey, if you're not for zero waste, how much waste are you for? And that, my friends, is a history of recycling according to the NCRA players. And now, on with the show.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. and Mrs. America, and all the ships at sea. Will you please join us for the Zero Waste NCRA Hour when we bring you the original 1940s radio show by the original cast. Here we are.
Join us for the NCRA Hour.
K NCRA.
future is ours to green. Que negra, negra.
Broadcasting live and on the front lines of the war on waste, I'm your host, Walter Winchell. Our radio show brought to you by Green Mary, Queen of the Clean. From the Pride Parade to the plains of Pittsburgh, no mess is too big for her to clean up. Date by 2019, it's been 20 years since the founding of the Nickel Players, but we still have waste. Dateline, Guangdong, China. The effects of the national sword have been felt around the world. China does not want our garbage, not even our mixed paper, mixed plastic, or mixed drinks. Dateline, Rancho Cucamonga. California has become a hotbed of hot rot, a depot of diversion, the seismic center of sequestration. Rancho Mirage, birthplace of the Rancho Mirage decision. This California hideaway has been host to movie stars and presidents. Now zero waste glitterati from around the globe have gathered to finally sort out the whole mess. Godspeed to them. Dateline, Berkeley, California, not content to be known as just the birthplace of the free speech movement, Berkeley is laughing at its sister zero waste cities by replacing all single-use disposables with reusables. Take that, San Francisco. And now, a word from our sponsors, Sudbusters, washing your way to zero waste. Entertaining the troops on the front lines of the sorting lines. The original, the one and only, the first 3R sister.
We want you, as a new recruit. We want you, and you.
on the war on waste. We are so happy that we want you to not do anything to discharge anything but honorable discards. No more snafus. That's why we want to recruit you as a new recruit. A recruit, it's one of the four R's. We need recruits to reduce, reuse, and recycle, right?
Yes.
And our troops are down in the dumps. They don't think we can get anybody to recycle properly anymore. It's such a mystery. What is it that we can do to get people to sort things into the right bins? Well, whatever it is, we've got to do what it takes to sort it all out for our troops on the front lines. You know, that's right. I think it should be mandatory. We want Uncle Sam to recycle. We want you to help Uncle Sam recycle. We don't want Sam to be down in the dumps.
I get it. We want paper drives, metal drives, rubber drives. Banana peel drives. No more mixed messes. Otherwise, it just all goes down to the dump.
That's right. Don't go down to the dump, Sam. Remember, reduce, reuse, and recycle right.
Thank you.
backstage, back in the green room. My story was unfolding.
I thought we were in CRRA, not Geezer Snortfest.
I know, between Walter Winchell, the three R sisters, I mean, what is this? I feel like the 1940s called and said, how many songs are you going to recycle tonight?
God, this is totally a Snortfest. But check out all the celebrities we have out there. I see the Stopways gang over here.
Right
there. I see Timothy over there.
That's not right there.
And I see the San Francisco Mafia over there. Hashtag LOL. Hashtag Coachella Rose. Hashtag CRA 2019.
Hashtag what? Now I feel old.
I feel old too, yeah. What? Oh my God, here they come now. It is the Pat Rat Pack. They are so fucking famous. They're the reason why Rancho Mirage is on the mat. Look here, it's Dean Martin, Joey Bishop, and Peter Lawford.
And you must be...
Wait, here it is. Mr. Peter Lawford, welcome so much. I'm so glad you're here.
And you must be Jimmy Dean.
Excuse me. It's Dean Martin. The, you know, the king of cool, famous actor and singer.
Well,
you know.
With this Snapchat filter, check this out. Now you're Diana Martin.
What's that? What did you say?
I like an old fashioned.
Me too.
Yeah, make that three.
Right away.
Hey guys, this is Waste Expo at 10 a.m. on the convention floor. Don't drink here.
Excuse me, do you know our establishment? Our craft drinks are made with poise, beauty, and personality. San Francisco Fog distilled vodka, paired with pesticide-free range flowers from the San Jacinto Mountains.
As long as it's got hooch in it, I'll take one.
Very interesting. But something is missing.
Yeah, there's no straw.
What gives, sweet?
Sir, but we're strictly a straw-free establishment.
Sir, you do not need a straw. Straws are so not cool.
Hey, we've been cool forever. Yeah. Invented cool.
I don't think you need a straw, sir. I don't think you need one.
What about compostable straws? Those must be good.
Yeah, you mean like those compostable straws we saw on Amazon made of cannabis trim and recycled shoelaces?
Not that kind of compostable.
I think I'd rather use my cigarette.
Really? Well, that just reminds me, there's this straw that they're made of fingernail clippings. And in fact, cigarette butts, too.
Ugh, not me.
Those are all greenwashed alternatives that just play into the single-use convenience culture we have to get away from. Yeah. What about all these single-use disposables that end up in the trash, may be recycled, but probably end up in the trash? We have to say, no straws.
No straws!
No, I don't want your plastic, no. I just suck on my endo. Got a couple of plastic, no. I want
crusted. If your straw is crusted and you're thinking, oh yes, y'all, I'm talking to you. If you're sitting in a plastic bitter, oh yes, y'all, I'm talking to you. Need a metal straw for your boba, oh yes, y'all, I'm talking to you. I got a paper straw with a soggy timber.
They've been found in takeout foodware, china plates, children's school lunch trays. These Teflon-like substances are persistent in the environment and are potential endocrine disruptors. EPI, the biodegradable products institute, is trying to come up with a solution, but they expect pushback from Georgia-Pacific, the American Chemistry Council, Dunder Mifflin, probably this guy. Probably this guy. In unrelated news, back in June, authorities in Riverside County seized 70 tons of pot worth an estimated $190 million. The confiscated weed was buried at the Lamb Canyon landfill. As you can imagine, this is very frustrating for me, as clearly this could be a problem. But then, on the CRRA listserv, Michael Simonides pointed out that reuse is much higher than the hierarchy.
In other news, California Senate Bill 424, sponsored by Senator Hannah Beth Jackson, has become a two-year bill. This bill would prohibit a person or entity from selling, giving, or furnishing to another person of any age in this state a cigarette utilizing a single-use filter made of any material, an attachable and single-use plastic device meant to facilitate manual manipulation or filtration of a tobacco product, and single-use electronic cigarettes or vaporizer device.
Yeah. Good thing it only applies to tobacco products here, right?
Yeah, right you are, man. Hold on to your butts, everybody.
For more serious news, we learned, and sad news, we learned this month that Replant, California's largest convenience zone recycling operation, would be closing and laying off 750 employees.
What?
This is California. We have the most aggressive legislation on the planet to keep organics out of landfills. We're going to ban single-use plastics. We're going to reverse global climate change. We can't figure out buyback recycling? What is this, 1986? What's it going to take? We raise the feet of a quarter? A buck a can. A buck a can. And then my dad.
In other climate news, according to the new UN report, global warming outlook is much worse than originally predicted, which is pretty bad because they originally predicted that it would destroy the whole planet. President Trump has a plan, though. He says that if we need to, we can lower the temperature dramatically just by switching from Fahrenheit to Celsius. Climate change by making extended forecasts that will help people plan for extreme weather. Because what could go wrong when you combine the efficiency of government and the accuracy of a weatherman?
You know, Rick, speaking of climate, in the U.S. there's a lot of talk about how global warming will be a disaster for future generations. But when I think about it, it's kind of hard to care. What have future generations ever done for us?
According to a new poll, Congress now is less popular than head lice, Nickelback, and Donald Trump. In a related story, head lice is insulted being lumped in with Donald Trump and Nickelback. A top geneticist from Stanford says human intelligence is declining. You know what that means? We are seeing Congress as its smartest and most effective right now. In the good news category, a suspected rhino poacher in South Africa is trampled to death by an elephant and then eaten by lions. On the flip side, thawing ice in the Alaska Denali is exposing 66 tons of frozen poop left by generators of mountain climbers. On the WTF side, Senator Mike Lee of Utah says the solution to climate change is to fall in love, get married, and have some kids. WTF. So, more WTF in the Trump election campaign. They've come up with a plastic straw that is recyclable and says Trump on it. The Democrats are considering a paper straw that says Trump sucks.
Speaking of straws, a lot of us here at CRA are eager to adopt not using plastic straws. These days, big airlines, big corporations, even some countries are banning the use of single-use plastic straws. Yeah. And, you know, Nick, banning plastic straws is cool and stuff, but have you ever tried a complete overhaul of the consumerist culture that perpetuates inequality and resource allocation and increases irresponsible production used by a fraction of the population?
Now, I wanted to introduce today the composter of the year, but I'm told that they are outstanding in the field.
We're signing up, and I'm back up.
And I'm Rick Anthony. Good night.
Thank you, gentlemen, for joining us on the road to Rancho Mirage. We will see you on the road to recovery. Okay, now all of you wax waves, G.I. Joes, airmen, squids, jarheads, crackerjacks, and all other military personnel, it is to our pleasure to introduce to you, just back from their UFO tour, that's the United States of America. Behind enemy lines at the landfill, the SB-31383 sister.
Everyone, we're the 1383 sisters, your fruit salad of entertainment. Woo! My name is Cindy Clementine.
And I'm Marty Mania. And I am Jessie Juju B. You know, ladies, I don't know, maybe it's just me, but lately I can't seem to
going? How's it being collected? Who's processing it?
Exactly. How many here feel the same exact way? Is it driving you crazy? Yes! It is like CalRecycle is seeping into every portion of our being.
It's giving me nightmares. I can't sleep at night.
There's been so many revisions. I'm still confused about the standardized container color.
Is the landfill color black or gray?
Oh, it's gray. Yeah, it's gray. But it can also be a darker shade of gray that can look like black, but it's not black because the law says it has to be gray. So it can look like black, but it's not black because it's gray. Just a darker shade of gray that happens to be, well, black. That makes sense? Well, I hear that Long Beach is still fighting for purple.
But my favorite color is pink.
Mm. Okay.
Blue. We need blue in order for people to recycle right.
And then there's the organics container.
Now, it's still green, isn't it?
Yes, and then there's the food waste, and I think that's yellow with a black lid or black with a green lid.
It's like, okay, what am I talking about here, right? Do I have the organic container? Do I have the food waste container? And then someone's like, oh no, we can't do yellow because it's gonna fade. No, I'm gonna have a brown lid. I'm gonna have a yellow lid. And then I think the thing is brown, but just next month, you don't know, it might change.
Well, I like the perfect solution. Why not polka dots?
Oh my gosh, who likes polka dots? CalRecycle, did you hear that? You know what? They're busy tonight. Don't worry. All of us here will submit a comment in the next 15 days.
Oh my gosh, ladies. It's so confusing. But you know what? The collection and the processing is not the most important part of SB 1383 and more and mandatory organics recycling.
No, exactly, yes. We want to reduce greenhouse gas emissions. Yes, we want to reduce methane in the landfill, but what's so beautiful about this piece of legislation is that we get to get to that edible food before it is ever wasted.
Feed people, not landfills.
And with 1 in 8 people experiencing food insecurity, the MORE program is very important.
So important. Of course I have more. Just hold on 1 second, okay? Here you go. Oh, and look, we have another one. Here you go.
Thank you. Thank you.
Oh, you're welcome. Aren't you so cute? Yes. Oh, thank you.
There's tons more where that came from.
Waiting for if we live till 84 seems like the same old rules. Every day we say our prayer, will they change the bills up there? Still we get the same state rules. Sequestration, conservation, digestion, biogas, reducing carbon, every
like a nice strawberry margarita.
Made with rescued strawberries.
Of course, what other way is there?
Ladies, you know what? I think we got this. All of us here, I think we got this. SB 1383 is all gravy, all of it. And what about you, little ladies? What do you think about food recovery?
Good, more food for everyone.
And what do you think?
Good, more food for everyone.
Yes, so brilliant.
Cool, so can you come on?
Well, folks, that's all we have for you tonight. You've been a great audience. You know what? Just remember, feed people, not landfills. Good night.
And now, watch your screens for a word from our sponsors, the Banana Advisory Council, or BAC, because bananas back you up.
Banana in a mouth. Half of my fruit bowl is banana in a mouth. You know I buy only organic banana. Although the price is kind of mammoth, I don't go into panic.
Banana.
On the go banana, you can grab her.
No other snacks are
good. Could she come with her own wrapper?
Instead of in
the meat banana, you look dapper.
Accessorize with
two. You make a kick-ass clapper. Organic na na na.
still more consternation going on.
I hate cleaning up after the liquor players. Such slobs! Look, they're also hypocrites. You know what those liquor players are? They're just a bunch of single-use deplorables. And they can't even sort. Look, I mean, everyone knows how to sort their recycling, right? It's easy, right? Easy, right? Like, this is paper. So obviously, it goes in recycle.
Yeah.
Easy. Rejected. Oh, wait. It's paper, but it's food soiled paper. So clearly, it gets composted. It goes to organics over here. Obviously. Sorry. Oh, wait. It has plastic on the paper, so we can't compost it. So, sorry, it's supposed to go in garbage. That was right. That's it. Seriously? Let's do something easier. Okay, this is easy. This is plastic. Plastic. Has those chasing arrows on it. It says number 5, right? Even says recyclable on it. So clearly, this is recyclable. All right, this is even easier. It says right on it, compostable. Easy. Compostable, right? Wait, this one said recyclable, and this one said compostable. Is it all just a bunch of bull?
Thank you.
outside. Meanwhile, back at the garden terrace, outside, there was something afoot.
But I have a little problem. See,
is this about the drinking? We already know about that.
There is a hole in my shoe, dear Liza. There's a hole in my shoe, dear Liza. A hole.
Fix it, dear Dino. Dear Dino. Dear Dino. Just fix it, dear Dino. Dear Dino.
But where can I fix it, dear Liza, dear Liza? But where can I fix it, dear Liza? Oh, where?
At the cobbler, dear Dino, dear Dino, dear Dino. At the cobbler, dear Dino, the cobbler.
The cobbler has died. Dear Liza, the cobbler has died, dear Liza. He's dead.
Find another, dear Dino, dear Dino, dear Dino. Find another, dear Dino, another.
There isn't another one around, dear Liza, dear Liza. There's no one. Fix these shoes, dear Liza. No one.
Let's send them. There's...
What do you want me to do? Return them?
Return them, dear Dino. Dear Dino. Let's return them, dear Dino. Dear Dino. Exchange.
Well, they were shipped from China, dear Liza. Dear Liza. They're from China, dear Liza. Too far.
We'll email, dear Dino. Dear Dino. Dear Dino. We can email, dear Dino. Dear Dino. And email.
Their website's in Chinese, dear Liza, dear Liza. Chinese characters, dear Liza. I can't.
All right. You know what? You're right. I happen to have a bag right here full of shoes that are broken, and I don't know where to repair them either. I'm tired of this. Shoes? Oh, remember these. We had such a lovely night dancing all night. The sunrise, the hot springs. Labor to produce them, greenhouse gas emissions to ship them all the way overseas, and here they are. We know they don't make them like they used to, and we feel like there's nothing we can do about it. You know what? I'm at it. I am outraged. We need to do something.
Me too.
I think I am going to start doing more research on my suppliers and manufacturers to find ones that stand by their products, make quality materials, provide reuse options, provide repair parts, have repair manuals, everything. I am not going to shop and buy another thing. You know what we need, Dino? We need a repair manifesto. Ooh.
Well, I'm with you now, dear Liza. Dear Liza, I'm with you now, dear Liza. I'm with you.
Let's go forth, dear Dino. Dear Dino, dear Dino. Let's go forth, dear Dino. Dear Dino, go forth.
Go forth where? Dear Liza, dear Liza, go forth where, dear Liza, where?
To the repair cafe, dear Dino, dear Dino, dear Dino. To the repair cafe, dear Dino, repair.
And how do I get there, dear Liza, dear Liza? And how do I get there, dear Liza? How?
We'll walk there, dear Dino, dear Dino. Dear Dino, we'll walk there. Put your shoes on, dear Dino, we'll walk.
There's a hole in my shirt.
Breaking news, we bring you now, live from the climate strike in Berlin, Germany. Young people from across Europe are sick and tired of the fact that the biggest generation, that is the biggest generating, are not doing anything in response to the climate emergency. Let us take you now live to our reporter on the scene.
Thank you, Walter. I'm here now with Greta Thunberg, the reluctant leader of her generation. Greta, we're live on the radio. Please keep this PG rated.
Oh, sorry. You are all effed up.
You want to expand on that, Greta?
Yes. For the past 20 years, and all of my life, you've been given the opportunity to get California to zero waste. And yet, where are we? With sea level rise, hurricanes, terrible floods, fires, mass extinction, locusts. And yet, where are we?
Gee, Greta, what can we do? Is there any hope?
Yes. For the past 20 years, we've been given pep talks. But what we need more than hope is action. Will wipe the planets out. No life will be left of this, I have no doubt. But don't forget that you deserve it. You know I don't jest. Yes, it's all for the best.
Hey, Rancho Raj, the Pack Rat Pack is back.
We invented cool.
That's right. We've heard it's really cool now that Rancho Mirage is zero waste.
What's zero waste?
Everybody knows. You know, it's when you, when they,
According to the Zero Waste International Alliance, zero waste is the conservation of all resources by means of responsible production, consumption, reuse, and recovery of products, packaging, and materials without burning and without discharges to the land, water, air that threaten the environment and human health.
That's no wasting!
That's a no wasting!
You know what else is really cool? SB 1383.
What's SB 1383?
Oh, I know.
Yeah, it's
a short term climate action act of 2016. It's about reducing greenhouse gases from sources that have a disproportional impact on our global warming potential, like methane and F gases and hydrocarbons and all sorts of other things.
I get it now. We were zero waste before it was even cool.
That's right. You know what? That reminds me of a song. You ready, guys?
Oh, yeah. That's it.
In Rancho Mirage, where we are kings, when we see zero waste, we sing. When a full rescue guy hits a big pizza pie, that's so great. When a vine seems to shine with sustainable wine, that's no wasting. Bills will ring, recycling, composting, reusing, that's no wasting.
We will
ban ticky-tacky crap and let it pass in crap, that's no wasting. When your mitts full looks like pasta puzzle, that's no wasting. When it's a compost, not oil, and it's red, when the city is still abused and the earth's not abused, that's no wasting. Susie B, can't you see we're in California? That's no wasting. When the light seems to shine with sustainable light, that's no wasting. Birds will ring, processing, ting-a-ling-a-ling, bottles sing, that's no wasting. Even if shoes, dicky-kicky-goo, out of the barn, bins of blue, that's no wasting. Goes in a circle.
Hey, that's a pretty nice program, fellas.
Hey, Frank, Paul Bluebeard himself, did you hear us sing?
Yeah, did you like it, Frank?
It was just what we needed to rally the troops and inspire them to carry on. Hey, did you just love it, everybody?
You know, Frank, we love the way you do it. We'll always follow your way.
Hey, we'll do it our way, boys. It's going to take each of us to get to zero waste.
Yeah, that's right, Frank. You know what, Frank? You take the line. You hit it, Frank.
Thank you.
for tonight, brought to you by Green Mary's, Scentbusters, the Banana Advisory Council, the Albatross Coalition, CRRA, and the Northern California Recycling Association. Your authorities are an absolute zero. Remember, next year, 2020, takes us to Burlingame by the Bay. Thank you for being such a great radio audience for the Zero Waste Hour on K-NICRA.
K-NICRA, NICRA, whatever you see will be. The future is ours to green. K-NICRA, NICRA, what you see will be. K-NICRA, NICRA.
Let's give it up for the NICRA players, the Scentbusters. The Originals, we are sisters. Doris Day and the Fancy Dancers. Sisters and friends. Liza Minnelli and Dee Martin. The Rat Pack Rats. And Frank Sinatra.
Plastic. One can face our biggest fear. I'm afraid there are no other answers here, so there's no better chance for you.